Devon. Where would we be without its stupidity, not forgetting the freaks, and more importantly, myself? Sure, we have our special Clingfield fanatics, and mostly not forgetting our lovely ladies. Drinking, slapping, shouting. Well, people, this is Devon, and this is Scott Vision. Really, what more can you expect from me? Yeah, I live in the Twilight Zone, but they do say mental health affects 1 in 4. Not in our case, more like 1 in 1. Still, this is my YouTube channel. Now let's enjoy life. Let's not forget the cops and the sirens and, oh, the fighting, the violence. Who knows what you can expect around the corner of West End. This is real Scott Vision.
Well, this is my blog for the end of 2009, which is nearly coming soon. I might recap on the events of 2009 that have taken me by surprise. It's been going on with that idiot little thing I'll say name of. So, in the start of 2009, I met a girl called Rachel. Blimey. Biggest mistake of my life, all the problems, all the bleeding social workers, lucky, everything like that. And, you know, it made me think to myself, actually, maybe I'm just too helpful to people. You know, when I'm doing this for people, doing that for people, I look where it ends me up with absolutely nothing. But then I got to look on the positive side of things this year. I mean, I've met so many good people like Rebecca, Tasha, Rhea. Should have said Rhea first. I don't know why that came out. I think I was trying to put it alphabetically, but... actually, that's not even alphabetic, is it? So, I just think to myself, I've met such good people, you know. And look at the trouble that Rachel caused, you know, with bloody Roy and me. I'm just pretty glad me and Roy are speaking again, you know. I really thought that was going to be the end of it now. We didn't speak for 4 months. But hey-ho, we're speaking again now, you know. And I tell you, it makes me think in some ways, some of the best things we've got in life is the people we have friendship with. So I decided to film this video while walking for no apparent reason down Bridgetown, Totnes. So what else we had? And then this year I got chased by Mr. Green, who wanted to wrap me up for a Christmas present this year, probably in a raincoat. You know, I just think to myself, you know, why do we meet bad people? And I just think passage we're supposed to learn from this, from experience, you know, from God, you know, but, hey, still, we all can't be idiots like raincoats and cling film, can we? Speaking of which, you've got to be careful playing around with that, because you never know, I might upset someone called Tracy Goodwin. Yeah, so, that's just an example of what's going on, you know, I've met up with old friends like Colleen, things like that. Colleen, oh my god! Well, I suppose, you know, it's funny to laugh at now with some of the problems she can be sometimes drives me up the wall. And I have pity for the poor girl because she's still stuck in London. And then I got to think of the biggest thing that's changed me, that sorted my life out so much, is meeting Rhea. Well, if I didn't know Rhea, I don't know what I'd be doing now for crying out loud. She's not, I don't think I'd even have sorted things out with Roy kind of thing. But there's also like people that have done so much for me over the year, you know, and I haven't actually thanked them, so I'm going to thank them over YouTube. And the main person I've got to thank over YouTube this year is you, Holly. You have done so much for me. I wouldn't even have think of contacting him. It went for you just saying, come on, it's time to ring him. You know, what would I have done if I hadn't spoken to Roy this year? You know, I wouldn't have sorted any problems out. I probably wouldn't have been able to help anyone out. So, thank you, Holly, if you're watching this. You know, you're my mate, and I will always respect you for that. And that's nothing to say to me, I'm going to say. That you can take good advantages, take good advice from people that might even be teenagers, you know. If a 13-year-old has to tell me, perhaps it's time to sort things out with your mate, you know, someone that's 9 years older, younger than me, gosh, has got to tell me that. Maybe it's a thing that I've noticed some of the older people should learn this year. I mean, it irritates me. Some people so much like my age, even older than me, are so, I've got no time for teenagers these years. I thought it was bad when I was a teenager, but it's got worse this year. So, you know, maybe it's time, actually time, some of you actually listen to some of the teens out there these days, you know, what they want to do. And, you know, maybe then we'll actually get somewhere in life, you know, we could all get along, you know. And not being disrespectful, but they say, you know, I'm going to put it, they say, you know, they say the elderly moan all the time, but and say it's always the kids, but it's not. I've seen this over there. Come on, like, windows being slammed on buses, and then deer's moaning. Oh, I'm going to get the police on you because you shut the window. I mean, come on. I'm not having to disagree with you, my dears and sirs, but come on, we've got to sort this out. We've got to try and get along. You know, 2010 yet, just try and change everything, but whether we will is anyone's guess, but still. But as we had on the show recap, I met my good friend Sam, Samantha, who I'm sure lives around here, is probably watching it at the moment, so you're watching, hello Samantha, trying to hear other things going on for me, and, you know, I just thought, you know, I would never, I got to try so hard never to be fooled by someone in need again. Because I tell you, as you, some of you know, I have been completely depressed with all this stress with Rachel and all that. I didn't need it. You know, and I still got to worry about next flipping year when I've got other problems to sort over there and all. So, you know, I've got all these other things going on, whatever that, for a drunken YouTube video, which apparently was deemed offensive just because we were winding up a complete tosser called Nick, sorry, and things like that. But, you know, I can't actually say names. things, but... And I got a bloody Geordie copper that thinks she's the next best thing in science place bothering me with her little walk she does. Look at me. So, yeah, so, 2009, what a year. But, you know, 2009 has also brought good friends back, like Emma. You know, me and Emma haven't seen each other. You know, for instance, the age of 9 now, we're still here for each other. It's nice, you know, we've still got that authority and respect going between each other. We respect each other's opinions. We never take advantage or anything out. We've always treated each other the same, you know, and things. But, you know, I'm actually thinking soon, what am I doing with my life? You know what I mean? It's just like, there's nothing. I don't know what I want to do in life, you know, and I still don't know now, you know. After all this year, I still do not know what I want to do. But, this maybe I'll actually find something to do this year. You just never know. So, I'm now walking down all the way from Westernfields, recording a video. I didn't even want to go Westernfields, I just recording a video the first bus I got on. And I thought, hey, I've done top notch, it's recording Westernfields. So, this about concludes my video blog. I look forward to seeing you all in the new year. I shall see you all soon. And a few more things I want to say to people this year. Right, kids, this is a word I've actually met Santa Claus, and I want to say to you, he's telling me you'll just be good this rest of this year, because if not, he won't be delivering any of your presents. And I mean it. So, be good for Santa. That includes you two parents and adults that are watching this. And I'll speak to you all soon. This isn't the end one for the year, but there will be more, but maybe we'll cut it down a bit. So I'll speak to you all soon. Bye now.